Good evening, folks, and a hearty welcome to our drive-in theater. We have a wonderful evening's entertainment lined up for you, one that will provide several hours of pleasurable relaxation and diversion for you and your family. Did you fail to dress up for tonight's show? No tie, an old shirt and slacks, a house dress? Well, don't give it a thought. We're glad you came as you are. We just want you to enjoy yourselves. Don't forget to visit our refreshment center during the intermission or any time. You love the tasty array of snacks we have to offer. So will the youngsters. Everything is quality and so good. We hope you'll make this a weekly visit. Bring the family. Bring your friends. There are always wonderful new pictures to see, delightful snacks to nibble, a gay, pleasant evening for all. Oh, a word of caution. Don't drive over 10 miles an hour in the theater area for your safety's sake. And Mom or Pop, go with the kids when they leave the car. We hope you have a wonderful time. Come back soon.
All right. Sunday night is here again, and you know what that means. It's time for another double feature. Tonight we have some fun JD / rock and roll movies from American International Pictures, Motorcycle Gang, and Hot Rod Gang. Rock and roll was pretty big in the late 50s, as you may well know. So were the horrors of juvenile delinquency. How could AIP not exploit the subjects and kick out some movies? Writer Lew Rusoff, who wrote both of tonight's movies, was responsible for many of the best AIP horror and sci-fi of the 50s, such as The Day the World Ended, It Conquered the World, and The She-Creature. He also produced Panic in Year Zero. Director Edward L. Cahn was no slouch either. He did films like Invasion of the Saucer Men and It, The Terror from Beyond Space. Star John Ashley, of both movies, was in a ton of AIP movies, primarily JD movies, up until he broke this typecasting to do a number of the Beach Party movies. I'm not a fan of those at all. My personal favorites of his, though, were the Blood Island films. Just killer exploitation horror from the Philippines. Enough of me. On with Motorcycle Gang.
Thank you. Let's go.
Well, they've gone back to the racing forms.
Hey, what are you trying to do, start a fire?
Well, for a minute I thought you departed planet Earth.
Not this week. Got a date on Saturday night.
I accept. Where we go?
What have you been smoking? Salmon?
Teresa Lindsay. Teresa?
Terry.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Tried to stick me with Randolph, but it's Randy to all who love and admire me.
Such first aid my mother warned me about.
Oh, 1, 2, 3, testing.
Can you put the kind of cup tag often?
No, I could carry it away.
Hey, I thought you used this spot for other purposes, too.
Yeah, just a little nature study.
Well, look, I know all about the birds and the bees and characters like you. Let's go.
Take it easy. It's open season on sickle hounds. They're still looking for us.
How long do we stay here? 3 weeks?
I'm game. Can you cook?
Oh, boy, you must be the life of the party with those jokes of yours.
We can go rescue your friend now, doll.
If anyone needs saving, it's Rand. Yeah, and I'll bet you're the one that can do it, too.
Hey, hey, don't tangle with Marilyn. She's a miger. I'm warning you.
What?
Oh, I forgot. You're not hip to this new lingo. Miger, mad tiger. Hey, if you girls have to fight, make it about me.
Oh, expire, clown. I promised to send flowers.
Ah, come on.
I thought I knew every sickle cat in town.
Well, I'm from a foreign land. Oh. Chicago.
Well, welcome to the USA. How long are you staying? Where and what's your phone number? Oh, answer in any order, please.
Well, my parents are away seeing Europe, so I've been exiled to my uncle's ranch near Saratosa.
Saratosa? It's where we're holding the PMG race. And that's real cool sickle country. Oh, you're staying for the summer, I hope.
Until I drive my Uncle Ed nuts. He's trying to wean me off of motorcycles. On the cows or something, I guess.
How about that phone number?
Well, we communicate by smoke signals. Oh, my uncle was an Indian fighter.
Like Speed would say, you're a shawl.
Huh?
Oh, a sharp doll. Off and on a wheel.
Burning rubber is my one big vice. Last guy who tried this lost an arm and a leg.
It'll be worth it.
You all right? Come on.
Yeah, I'm okay.
See tomorrow's episode of Love in the Ravine. Will the girl escape a fate worse than death? Or will she marry the drip, which is even worse?
The winner and still unsullied, Terry the Terrible!
And now, ladies and gentlemen, a word from the winner.
Twarn't nothing, Ma. I just see my duty, I've done it.
And now a word from the runner-upper.
Oh, beat it, you flop-eared nitwit.
Come on now, a word for your public. Come on.
Okay. It was a fixed fight. I took a dive.
It all goes back to an unhappy childhood. I was born in a little log cabin in Yamishlash. My mother was away at the time.
You know, I won a trophy once, but it was for endurance. 7 years in the sixth grade. Or was it 6 years in the seventh grade? Well, would you like to come up and see it sometime?
I can see it now, screwed into your neck. Solid bone and ugly.
You, I could like. How's your old man fixed for long green?
I know where you can buy a padded cell real cheap. Your size, too.
If it's next door to yours, I'll take it.
I'll see you down the hill, Randy.
Okay.
You counted me out down there. How about a rematch?
Send your manager around to see me when you're in shape. My hero.
Boy,
Undernourished, that's the trouble with me. Had only four meals today. Say, a bunch of us hot chewers hang around a joint called the Blue Moon. We're having a big meeting tonight. You're invited.
One of those organized clutches.
Pacific motorcycle groups.
Club char and all that jazz? That sounds like a real squash.
Well, I don't know about that. A little official blessing goes a long way in this sport. Come on, give it a whirl. 8:30.
Here's one member who will survive if she can't make it.
I don't know why, but your mother doesn't like me.
Oh, wait a minute. I know you want to see me again sometime, baby, so just give your message to any traffic cop. I'll get it. They got me, Dad. I died for love. Come on. Clown.
Well, she rides like you do. Like there's no tomorrow. Here I thought I was going to die of boredom this summer. I think I'll take in that meeting.
Yeah, some of those sky riders are pretty wild.
That's for me.
You gasoline-burning monster.
Now, faces, Uncle Ed. One day, these are going to replace horses. It's going to be a horseless world.
Yes? Well, you just try and convince a full-blooded stallion of that and see how far you get. You're all dirty, honey.
Yeah, I took a slight spill.
Yeah, I can't figure where you get this wild streak.
Hey, I'm reforming. I'm even thinking about joining a club.
Well, now that's the best thing I've ever heard. Gonna be poetry and sewing? That kind of a club, huh?
Yeah, and also instructions in the minuet.
Well, now, isn't that great? I'll bet you found yourself a fella. Is that the reason of this change?
A living wheel.
A wheel? Well, you just roll him by here someday and I'll take a look at him.
Boy, he handles a fuel bender like it's a rocket 90. In and out of trap.
Now, what kind of talk is that? They just don't make girls like they used to.
What's the matter, Uncle Ed? Has that changed, too?
Oh. Any of you squares out here going to part with a little lettuce? Everybody's out here scratching away rent-free. How am I supposed to make my tax bill for Uncle Sam?
I'll go for a malted.
You'd go for washing dishes. With what you owe me, I could bring out a wife from Hong Kong. Hey, Randy, did you try the fuel mixture I told you about?
Oh, not yet. I'm going to try the trials next week.
That should give your heap some white-out runs, man.
Yeah. Think she'll be around tonight?
Who? Oh, you mean the baby overwhelmed this PM? You still on the pillow about her?
Fantabulous, wasn't she?
Yes, she was. Wow, get those lightning rods out of here.
Go get yourself insulated. Put your dark glasses on. I'm having trouble with my crutch assembly. Will you check it for me?
Right here in broad daylight?
You're so funny, I could split your sides laughing.
Yeah, I'll take a look at it as soon as I finish the spit.
Look who's having trouble with their clutch assembly.
I'll count three, and you take your last breath.
You know, I had her there. She can't count past two. Hey, what does come after two? No reception committee? No glad hand? How do you like that? Away 15 months and they don't even remember my name. It's Rogers. Nick Rogers. Hello, Randy. Glad to see me.
Why not?
I'll bet.
Look, Nick, I'm sorry for what happened. What do you say we forget it?
Forget it? Forget 15 months in that lousy place?
I told you.
Look, here's how I forgot it.
Take it easy, Nick.
And you guys, this is my bad wall. If this joint goes down, I'll sue you.
Your chance, you muffed it. You're smart, you'll keep away from me. I'm not smart, kid.
Daddy, there'd be nothing but trouble now. They shouldn't have let him out.
Battering ram, you nearly got me.
Hey, boy, why didn't you join the Navy? They could use another aircraft carrier.
Hey, you're talking about the girl I love, to eat with.
You're a riot to be with. I had more fun the night I got locked up in the morgue by mistake. Stiffs couldn't see, but they looked at me.
I'm losing too much power on the takeoff. Overslide nearly all the time. Gotta figure a way to compensate.
You've got a one-cylinder mind.
I don't want to brawl in here. Positively no blood, huh? You guys go away. And I'm going to call the boys in blue. Get the picture?
It's in focus. The scene's made. Now cut out.
Nothing good, Marilyn.
Glad somebody thinks so.
I'm back. I told you I wasn't smart.
What are you trying to prove, anyway?
That I hate your guts for what you did to me. And I'm going to get even.
Finished your little speech yet?
For now.
Looks like the joint's gonna be jumping.
You know, old Nick wants his crown back, king of the yo-yos.
I bet he tries to break up the club.
I think I'll try a 10 GB carb and a 1/3-H choke.
Quiet genius at work.
Oh, hey, invent me 35 cents for a malted.
I'm desperate. I'll even dance with you.
Tell you what, I'll flip you. Loser dances with her.
I should live to be one of your pallbearers.
You know, he sees red when he looks at you.
He'll simmer down.
Not him. You know, he ought to make a flat deal with a psychopalanderness. That's sure.
Oh, never mind.
Hi, Bertie. Let's talk over tomorrow's menu.
You look better than I remember.
And I do remember.
That's not a bad opening line.
There'll be fur flying tonight.
Could be.
What'll it be, fingernails at 10 paces or hair pulling at 4?
She's more the outdoor type. Maybe an up and over to the weeds, off a gas tricycle.
Yeah. About dessert now.
Hi, chick. Another one. They spring up like bongo players at the beach, these sickle cats.
Meet Cyrus Q for Quincy 1.
closest he's ever been to the Orient is San Francisco.
Boston boy. What'll be for cash?
Hamburger. Rare and no onions.
One pony still living, no tears.
Oh, that's not all. He plays a rock and roll on a Chinese one-string harp.
Out slumming?
Well, I didn't think so until I saw you.
Introduce me.
Miss Caviar of 1957. Meet the head of Nick Rogers, Inc. The ink is for incorrigible.
See you later. And often.
Not dull moment around here, I'd buy that. Hi, Mohammed. Saw you dancing with your mountain.
You know, you must feed on cats. Hey, why'd you bring your girlfriend? You know, the one with the big ears?
Why didn't you go knock a hole in the wall with your head? We need some ventilation.
Well, I could take a hit, even if it's a subtle one. We've got some new times to talk over together. Well, why didn't you say so?
Hello, Nick. I heard you were back.
Yeah, Randy put in a good word with the parole board for me. You're in civvies, Lieutenant. How come? Night off?
I'm on special duty now, Nick, working with PMG Club.
Oh, you're the one that made a Sunday school class out of this joint, huh? Rules, regulations, charters.
Kids ask for it. You behave yourself. Maybe they'll let you join.
That'll be the day.
Oh, hi, Joe.
Hi.
Terry Lindsay, Lieutenant Watson.
Hi.
Can I see you a minute?
Yeah, I'll make it a short one.
Excuse us, will you?
Yeah.
I heard about you and Nick mixing it up last night.
Things get around.
Don't let him get to you, Randy. He's rotten.
It's not gonna be easy. The more I back away, the more you'll crowd me.
I know. But even a street fight's a misdemeanor. You understand?
Yeah.
Excuse me there. With him, you'll be breaking up a beautiful romance. Now, me, I'm unattached.
I shouldn't wonder.
Shall I leave now?
You give up easily.
Try and shake me now.
Come on, we better get the meeting started.
I better break one up.
All right, kids, the meeting will come to order.
First order of business, collection of dues. Marilyn?
I move the meeting be adjourned.
Marilyn, would you collect the dues, please? Now, since this meeting is concerned mostly with the PMG regional race next month, I'm turning the meeting over to Joe.
Here are the entry forms for the regional. 100-mile cross country to be held this year at Saratosa. You know, this race is open to all PMG club members in good standing. Any member wishing to may try to win the qualifying trials, which will be held next Tuesday. Top rider will represent the club at the regionals. For those of you who can't read.
Honest, Joe, I'm learning.
Shut him up, Bertie. Give him something to eat. It says here, eligibility shall consist of the following. Number one. Contestants shall be free of any arrests and convictions on major traffic violations for a period of 6 months prior to the Saratosa Regional. Number two, any member of a PMG club who has broken the club charter by an infraction of the safety rules shall, upon a majority negative vote of his group, be deemed ineligible to participate. I have a hunch that some of you guys came pretty close to losing your chance to go in this event. Boys tell me they clocked 3-4 strokers doing over 90 miles per hour on city streets.
Don't look at me. I was home fertilizing my petunias.
If anyone can do it, you can, Speed.
Can I leave the room, teacher? Because that's what this has become, a lousy nursery school. Everything we used to do, everything we used to have kicks doing, now all of a sudden it's illegal because the cops say so.
You're out of order. You're not a member.
You're telling me. I'll take things as they used to be. All these rules and regulations, that's kid stuff.
Nick wants the good old days back again. When every kid on a motorcycle was looked on as a criminal with a loaded gun. And it was. He should know that. You know why he really liked things as they were? Because you let him throw his weight around, be a somebody. He's nowhere, and he knows he's nowhere in this kind of a setup.
You and your cop psychology. I had 15 months of it, and believe me, I'm sick up to here. There any guts left in this place? Or did you turn them all in when you went for this lousy charter? Anyone for some real riding? Now! Let's get out of here. Let's go.
Yeah, man, let's check up.
A couple of characters like that can louse up the whole play. Meeting's over.
It's club stuff. Really boxes you in, doesn't it? I guess I'm the rebellious type like Nick.
How's your hardware look?
Oh, Breeze Lightning ought to be able to take the qualifying race, I hope.
Think she'll do 90 on a city street?
I wouldn't know.
Don't try to find out again. Or there'll be no race for you or anything for quite a while. I'm still a policeman, Randy.
You two sound like you're talking in code. Decipher, please.
Oh, some other time. After we get acquainted. Let's start now.
When you say get acquainted, you really mean it, don't you? I think Marilyn just stuck a knife in my back. Would you take a look, please?
All's clear on the straightaways, and I can't see around the curves.
These bums can't give me a ride, Randy. How about you and me cutting the
queue? I'm busy.
Terry will excuse you. She might even like to watch the fun.
Take him on, Randy.
What's the matter, you yellow kid?
You were going somewhere. Go.
Saved by the bull.
Well enough acquainted now. Now tell me about you and the lieutenant.
I just don't want to talk about it.
What's the matter with you? You holding out on me?
Okay. I'm on a 2-year suspended sentence. He was just reminding me of it.
2 years? What for?
I guess you might as well hear it from me. One night a couple years ago, Nick and I were doing some hot riding. He'd had a few beers, and I was riding behind him and made a sharp turn around a corner and knocked an old guy down. It was too late for us, so I'm lying there, and I went right over him.
That's tough.
Well, the old guy knocked off a couple weeks later. Nick wanted me to lie, so I saw the old guy run in front of him. I wouldn't do it. He got 1 to 5, and I got a 2-year suspended sentence. Nick figures I put him in jail. That's why he's out to get even. He knows I can't fight back without breaking probation.
Okay, get him in a back alley and try and give him a good licking. That'll get him off your back.
He can't take me in a fight. He won a duel on Sickles in front of all the gang, so he can be a big wheel.
Look, the cops aren't everywhere.
I'd be breaking club safety rules. It'd wash me out of the race. Worked 3 years to get a chance at that trophy.
So how come you forgot your scruples when you played cop tag this afternoon?
I got trapped. Before I knew it, I had to run or get sent to prison.
What's so big about winning the regional? So they give you a tin cup with your name on it. And then you win the national. And another tin cup. And so on. And so what?
My mother and I live in a small apartment over near the oil refinery. She has to work so I can go to school. In summer, she's waiting on tables in some dump near San Francisco.
Oh, what's that got to do with it?
Well, all my life, I've been just another kid. Average this, normal that. I want out of that rut. I want to be the best at something I do. A third or second. But number one. If I can do that, I can prove a lot of things to myself.
Whew. You really take life seriously.
It's just maturity setting in. It's painless.
I hope it's not contagious. Me. I'm for the wild and crazy rides. The only young ones. And this may be that once.
You're funny. Talk tough. Handle a bike like nothing matters. But your eyes, they sure give you away. They say things your lips don't.
Don't you try to analyze me?
Afraid of what you'll find?
Sorry if I blew my top.
Yeah. I've been yakking like I've been breaking in a new tongue. Can I call you tomorrow?
Not tomorrow. I'm going riding with Nick.
Oh? He sure got in the act fast.
Nothing like a little competition to make things happen. What's the matter? Can't you take it?
I'll get my sword sharpened, Lady Genevieve.
On my way to the icebox. What time is it, honey?
Oh, after midnight, I guess.
After midnight? Wouldn't be a couple of hours after midnight, would it? Well, bless my horse thieving uncle. My watch says 2:30.
Oh, now, Unc, you must be on Japanese daylight saving time.
Hmm. Did you have fun?
The very most.
Hmm. Terry? Hmm? I don't know whether I like this or not.
Oh, men are dumb. You know, here I've just met a fella, and already I've got to straighten him out of a mess. Well, what would you guys do without women, huh?
Well, when you get to be a certain age, the question is what to do about them. Well, I'm glad of one thing, though, honey.
What?
You didn't let him paw you around.
Why, you old weasel. You were watching.
No, I wasn't at all. The window was up,
yeah,
and I went over there to pull it.
Good night, Unc. Good night.
Good night, sweet. Yeah, now I am hungry. She must have left a little chicken.
Something in the house?
I don't know, but I'm not gonna find out. You hit that stuff too hard.
Okay. I can get a little tired just looking at you.
Terry, you're so beautiful, honey.
No.
What's the matter? Is Randy beating my time with you?
No one's beating your time. I'm a free agent.
That's the spiel you give me. What dialogue do you use with him?
You know, you're a nice enough guy. Until someone mentions the name Randy.
Okay, we'll forget about it. We'll just talk about us. Honey.
You know, someone ought to take your two heads and bang them together. Just might knock some sense into them.
I guess I'm just jealous, Terry.
Jealous? You have no cause to be. I'm free and I'm single. And I'm going to keep it that way. Good night, Nick.
Okay, you win. Can I come by tomorrow and pick you up? We'll go watch Randy ride to glory in the qualifying trials.
All right, Nick.
Please, Terry.
All right. Good night.
Night.
You know, I better try to cinch up this front axle.
Great.
There's one race you're gonna lose.
It's not the big one.
Says he with a lump in his throat. What's she got that I can't buy? Set to go?
Look, I think I'll take the run, too.
Sorry, Chum, you're not eligible.
That's a big word in your vocabulary these days, Randy. Look, what does it mean? Chicken?
Get on your bike.
Take him away, Terry.
All yours.
Lieutenant, I just want to go along for the ride. I don't want any trophies, no medals, nothing. Just the ride.
What's the point?
I'll set the pace.
No dice.
You got all kind of friends.
Let him ride, Joe.
If you say so. Keep it clean or you'll hear from me.
Corner are you in anyways?
No corner. I'm staying neutral.
Someday you're gonna have to take sides.
We're waiting, Randy. You stay away from that Smith. Small drip. He doesn't care who wins as long as it isn't you.
What?
But go on, I like it.
Oh, this calls for a celebration.
Name it.
This weekend at the ranch.
Great.
Oh, and bring Speed. Darling's just mad about him. She's got some warped ideas about men.
It's a date.
Not bad. It took a little luck, but you won. You're pretty hot on a run, Randy, but how about a little close-in stuff where it takes a little nerve?
Oh, aren't you tired of that song and dance, Nick? I am.
That's what the club's done to you. Softened you up. Coming?
In a minute.
You know, you ought to take him on.
Leave me alone, will you?
Well.
He's making you look bad.
Well, I'm real sorry to disappoint you. But I'm not letting him bug me out of the regional. You can call that weekend thing off if you want to.
What for? As a matter of fact, let's have a real party. I'll invite the rest of the kids down for Saturday night. And you and Speed come about noon. We'll have a picnic, okay?
Hey, you got yourself a real job trying to feed Speed.
I love a challenge. Too bad you don't.
I don't read you at all.
Oh, I'm really quite simple, Randy. When you settle down as Uncle Ed, set us for keeps. Till then, I want to make the most of things. To you, this is a symbol of a future and a career, isn't it?
Yeah.
To me, it's a hair raiser. Something that'll do what I tell it to. I say go faster, and it does. I say take a turn, and it does. Ever since I can remember, someone's been telling me what to do. And this is the one thing I control.
You're kidding yourself. Beyond a certain point, the machine's the boss. I didn't want my bike to run over that poor old guy. And in court, I listened to him call me a killer.
That was a tough break, Randy. But you can't stop living because of the past. That's what's wrong with you. You're too conscious of courts and rules. I think Joe's brainwashed you.
Man, whoever built you sure knew where to put what.
Well, you just leave everything where it is.
You know, you must take acid pills. But I like you. You're a real brawl. Brawl, beautiful doll, get it?
Don't get any ideas.
I got them.
Well, forget them.
Forgot them.
Some arguments that can only be settled out of court by breaking rules.
You're referring to Nick.
Hell, no girl likes to see someone she thinks a lot of get pushed around.
Maybe I do need a good manager.
Like me?
When'd you like to start?
Yesterday.
Well, salary in advance?
What else?
Well, I'm a little short on the green, but here's something.
Better be getting home. Si's gonna be there with the food in a while.
Yeah.
Come on, you guys, let's eat, man. Come on. Dad, let's have some of them Chinese blintzes, man. Come on. What's the matter, Daddy? Are you on the penicillin or something? Come on, let's wiggle it.
What kind of language is that?
A foreigner. Come on, man, let's wiggle it.
House rules, no clinching.
Oh, Unky, don't you think you're awfully, awfully tired and you want to go to bed?
There'll be no sleep for me till this free-for-all is over. Now, break it up. I can't stand that racket. Reminds me of a lot of coyotes fighting over a carcass.
More like the mating ceremony of a Chinese goose.
And now is the time for him to hear some real music.
Oh, Unky, Unky, please, anything but that, baby. Not
now, that. Listen, honey. A man's home is his castle. Now, any of you kids want to dance a shottish?
Oh, it's awful.
Sounds a little like Guy Lumbago and his Royal Caucasians.
Let's jam it, Dad. You've got to give it a beat. You've got to go progressive.
Where did you get that Chinese shillelagh?
Roll it, man.
Some food.
Well, eat, drink, and be merry, for tomorrow's another day. You ready?
For what?
Oh, come on, Randy, we were dancing.
I didn't know Nick was coming.
Well, it was sort of open house. I didn't tell anyone not to come.
Sure of that? Wouldn't like to think you engineered it like this. He's out for blood.
You are afraid of him, aren't you?
I was supposed to wait till tomorrow to pick a beef with you.
Shut up, Nick.
It was supposed to look spontaneous. See, I had it all rehearsed. We're gonna have words, and then I was gonna challenge you to a run. You were gonna be cornered and have to say yes.
Nick.
But I couldn't wait, because I was afraid I'd forget my lines. I'm taking you on tomorrow, kid. We're gonna match guts, and one of us is gonna walk away the winner.
See me after the race.
I'm seeing you now, Randy.
Take him on, Randy, and get him out of your hair.
So you didn't know he was coming, huh?
It's for your own good.
Thank you, manager. I'd be no better than you if I let you get my goat.
On sickles, hero. This way I don't argue with you.
You've got to, Randy.
Anything to please the queen. She's got to have her kicks. Okay, big mouth. I'll take you on.
You've got me wrong, Randy, honest.
I've got you right for the first time.
Serious. Looks like the threads on the coupling may be a bit worn. Don't worry about it. It'll be all right.
Yeah, man. What'll it be?
Well, we'll start easy. Take turns. Follow the leader, I guess.
I'll string along until things get too hot.
That sounds fine. Anyone else?
Count me in, too.
This is our little picnic. Nobody else's. Anybody else rides, I don't.
Well, I guess that excuse is as good as any.
Hey, listen, any of you guys got any stomach pills over there? Because this guy has lost his.
You keep out of this.
I'll do what I like. Come on, Nick.
Now I know where the yellow went.
Get rolling.
Thank you.
Quiet!
Not for me. It's all yours, Terry.
You gave me a run for it. I'm glad I can quit now.
Wheel it. It was just a warm-up.
On the other side, takes this one.
You're crazy, Nick.
I agree. Look, is this where you want to go home?
Right on, McDuff.
Not me, there's a limit.
There is. That's a twist for you. You're leaking pretty bad, Nick.
No sweat, man.
Don't go on this one, please.
Tournament must go on for Her Majesty. A duel to the finish.
Don't talk like that.
All the spoils go to the victor and all that exhaust. I'll take him. And I'll collect now.
Look, get over to the other side and handle the timing, will you?
Call it off, Nick.
You're throwing the towel in for him?
Roll it. I got a little thing going for the next one I'll really send you.
You gonna handle the watch? I'm ready to go. That'll be hard to beat.
You're losing oil, Nick. You dropped oil all on the trestle. Stop him, he'll hit that oil.
He can't hear you anyway. might slow him down a little bit. He's not. It's no fault of yours. Someone call an ambulance, quick. You know, I don't think he would particularly like you around here, baby.
What's the matter, baby? Couldn't you sleep? Mm-mm. Oh, but it's a pretty night. You smell that alfalfa? How about Randy?
He got out of the hospital today.
Well, how come that you're here, then?
He can do without me. He's made that pretty clear. Oh, I don't blame him. I got him disqualified from the regionals next week. I saw to it that he broke every rule in the book. And on top of that, I nearly got him killed.
Oh, now why don't you just go and tell him that you're sorry?
I tried to, but he won't see me.
Well, make him. A fish won't bite if he can't see the bait, honey.
You've been talking to Darlene. You think I'm a stew aim, too?
A stew aim? What is that?
Oh, it's just being talked for stupid day.
Oh, now.
Oh, good night, Hook.
Good night, sweet. A stew aim.
Your uncle said you didn't even want to talk to me.
That's right, I don't.
I just thought I'd cinch that run over the trestle. Terry, I swear I didn't know he'd do it, Brody.
He could have been killed.
Don't get preachy, baby.
You'd have been a murderer.
You dreamed the whole thing up.
I think no more of myself than I do of you. I'm going in.
Terry, don't make out like I'm poison to you, please.
Take your hands off of me.
Please don't give me the brush off. Not like the rest of them. Honey, you and I are we're the same kind. We go for the same kicks.
Don't you ever, ever call me again.
Terry?
Honey.
Now, wait a minute. I was there, and he was shoved in toward it. It never got happened.
Sure.
Somebody's okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. You've made it, Dad, and you've got 8 lives to go. You know, I hope you don't feel as bad as Marilyn looks.
When shrinking heads becomes legal, can I have yours?
A pleasure, treasure.
Scoot, coot. Feel like a ride?
Nah, not much.
You're not with little Marilyn, are you? You're with a little soft pink cloud. Look close, then you'll see a name on it. It spells Terry.
Yerke Fritz. She's the one who put me where I am today.
This is killing me, but she did try to stop you from crossing that trestle.
Oh, sure, that's only part of it. She staged the whole thing from beginning to end.
I'd be... I guess I'll go home.
I'll take you if you like.
Such enthusiasm, like asking your spinster aunt for a date. Call her. You have my blessing. But if she drops dead, I'll be around to console you.
Boy, I wish you'd get through with that meeting in there.
I told Si it was a waste of time.
Terry, you've got to go in and see him. Now get in there. You're going in. Okay, come on, you're going to go in there.
Let's go, baby.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you? One night you told me that maturity was setting in. I said I hoped it wasn't contagious.
Yeah, I remember.
Well, it is. You said it was painless. But you're wrong, it does hurt. You know, it's amazing how wrong I've been about so many things. I realized it most when Nick said that he and I are one of a kind.
Thanks a lot for trying to stop me on the trestle.
Well, some people find it very hard to say I'm sorry, and I'm one of them.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Hey! Make with the leg you muscled. You're in!
Great! Come on!
Come on! Come on! Come on!
Some of the legal beagles cooked up a case for your being reinstated. I want you to know that I fought it with all I could.
We made him see the light. Fly, Si. Budge, Judge.
Since you broke the club charter in your little escapade, the kids felt that a full-fledged investigation was in order.
On with it. Quit the torture.
Anyway, it was unanimously decided that you were goaded into an infraction of the rules by an outside party. It was a consensus of opinion that you couldn't have acted other than you did. And since this was a matter for the group to decide, this somewhat prejudiced jury has found you not guilty.
Instructions to PMG regional contestants. You are all familiar with the course. There are three checkpoints. Officials will be on hand. The first is 30 miles out of Advil. The second is Carson. The third is Bellamy. Good luck and get ready.
I better get in line.
Good luck. Oh, you can do better than that, Terry.
That a screwy brainwave. I bet if we fell in behind the last line of riders this afternoon, we could run the whole course and they wouldn't even know it.
Hey, maybe if we started before they get to Advil, that would be a laugh.
Yeah, but we'll have to catch them at Advil. They're going to be going by any minute now.
Hey, it's last one.
Let's get some more. Come on.
I could use a drink about now.
Hey, here they come.
Well, what are we going to do? We're going to stand here, we're going to follow them.
Chase their tails?
That's kid stuff. For what? Hear them cheer the winner?
Yeah, and if that winner should happen to be Randy, huh?
Can't you just see that girl? Where's your sense of humor, Nick?
I'm a little tight. When I get that way, anything can happen.
You're only kidding, huh?
I could use a drink.
Let's go to that jerkwater town.
That's what I need, a drink. I'm with you.
That's the last of them. I'm going to catch them at the finish line.
The lunatics all gone?
All gone. Town's intact. Total population of 10 can now retire.
12. But 7 of them were safe. They're out in the field. You can come out, Mary. The war is over.
They just left Atville. They've got a lot of hill climbing to do between there and here. About an hour's worth, I'd say.
This town is really jumping.
Come on. Let it be.
What do you got to drink?
Coffee, soft drinks, milk.
Milk he's got.
Make it coffee, Daddy-o.
Got some nice fresh peach pie.
So.
Four peach pie.
Look, where'd you learn to make that lousy coffee? In jail? I want something stronger.
The sign says cafe, not bar.
That liquor store next door belongs to you?
It's been out of business for some time.
Now, I know you've got something in the back room, Pappy. Just go get it.
That's my business.
You shouldn't talk to Nick like that, Daddy-o. You insult him, you hurt me, too.
We need something to take away the taste of this coffee.
Yeah, how about that?
I don't sell liquor.
Then give us some.
Finish your food and get out of here.
You stink. Your food stinks. Here's what I got.
I'm calling the cops.
This guy is a panty.
I'll go take a look in the back and see if he's got something stashed back there.
Well, that's what I call planning ahead. Go on.
You stay out of there.
Sister!
No! No! No!
Shut up!
No, please! No, please! No!
Now you're a quiet one!
No!
Why would you keep quiet? Hey, hard stuff! Reinforcements.
What is it, Mary?
You saw a mouse.
What do we do with them?
Just let him sit there.
Now, we're going to entertain you. Is there anything special that you want? How about a circus? Huh? You like a circus? But there's no sense just entertaining these three because there may be some more customers around. Phil, you and Jack go outside and see if you can find anyone. If you can, just bring them in. I know. We'll ride for him, okay?
What time is it?
4 minutes since last time you asked. They aren't due for half an hour yet.
Car six.
You know, I go for these here police office perimeter taters, you know?
Hey,
catch those rock and roll police calls. And dig those crazy lyrics.
Okay, you guys, it's curtain time. You see, this isn't going to cost you a cent. It's simply our way of thanking you for the pie and the
ditch water.
You should have choked on it.
Oh, this one's got nerve. You know, maybe we'll use her in one of the numbers.
Better take them out back. Big field there. Lots of room.
After you, ladies and gentlemen. Ow!
Come on, daddy-o!
Enough? Uh-uh, this is only act one, my friend.
I need some fuel, Daddy-o.
The bottled kind. You got some?
No.
I've got some hidden away. Ah, yeah. I'll get it.
Okay, Aunt Mabel, you get it. But you make it snappy. Hey, Jack! Hey, listen, you go with her, watch her.
Yeah, General.
All right, now. We're going to have act two coming up right now. Hey, Hank. Hank, look, don't you think we ought to do a Johnny O'Neill for him?
Oh, go ahead.
Okay.
Hey, cool.
Get the police. Some of these motorcycle racers. Quick.
Foxy, huh? Thought you'd pull something like this. Who'd you call?
I didn't have a chance to call anybody.
Too fast for you, huh? But just so it doesn't happen again. All right. Let's come and get what you came for, huh?
Car number.
Any minute now.
All units in.
I think I hear him.
He's in the first 20. He'll win. No one will catch him.
All units, group 415 in Advil, will repeat. APB to all police officers. Report PMG motorcyclists in group 415 in Atville.
PMG riders, just what we need. Now, isn't this great?
I think I hear them.
I'll have to bust up the race. I'll need help. Some of the boys are roughing it up at Atville.
Well, why me? I got this thing in the bag. They can't touch me on the flat.
Randy.
I'm not telling you, Randy. I'm sure some of the others will help.
I'm sorry, Joe. Let's go. Let's take the shortcut over the hill.
Right. You just won yourself more than a race.
We need some audience participation because that way it'll make them feel more like they're in it, you know?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So, how about using them for markers in the slalom race?
You're a genius!
Okay. All right, come on with me. Everybody.
Look, we're staying right here.
A mutiny.
Back there.
Thank you.
Oh, one thing, folks. These aren't PMG men. They're alley cats on motorcycles. There's a big difference. Come on.
This is quite a victory celebration for a loser.
Loser? You've won everything in sight.
Everything?
With reservations, of course.
Hey, guys, a special treat, written especially for this occasion. With a little help, of course, of Beethoven and Bach and Irving Berlin and Taisho Sang Li.
No, oh, no! No, anything but that.
Hey,
Steve. Well, make your choice, Steve.
You know, a little brain work and you can have both.
Frap the gooch to get.
Man, there was so much leather in that one, it could have taken place at the Blue Oyster Bar. I did like the bikes, though, and the fight at the end, it was pretty well done. Okay, back to John Ashley. Did you know that he was one of the producers of the A-Team? Well, he was. Walker, Texas Ranger was also produced by Ashley for a few seasons. He was also a pretty successful theater owner, owning some 40 screens in Oklahoma before selling them off to a large national. In Hot Rod Gang, you'd see him doing some of his best to be a teen heartthrob, even performing some songs with the Bandy Forms. The director of Hot Rod Gang, Lew Landers, was pretty prolific. He had over 175 films to his credit before his passing in 1962. Strangely enough, he really didn't work in horror sci-fi except for one of his first films, the Universal classic The Raven from 1935, and the awful Terrified for Crown International. That was his last film, and it was released the year after his passing. Of course we've shown that one. Okay then, it's intermission time, and then Hot Rod Gang.
The show starts in 10 minutes.
You are invited to join the Banshees, the werewolves, the vampires, the gooks, who are all coming to our Halloween convention of spooks. You'll enjoy this lively group if your blood doesn't end up in the soup. Practice your screams. Break out your shrouds. Tighten your nerves. And join the crowds at our convention of spooks.
Once a normal, voluptuously beautiful woman, she drove into a nightmare of horror and saw descending from the sky a titanic monster whose fearsome touch became a frightful curse.
You think I'm drunk, don't you? All of you! I'm not drunk! I'm not! You've got to believe me!
Please.
It was right in the middle of the highway, 30 feet tall!
What, she's in the booby hatch? Throw the key away. That'll put you in the driver's seat. You'd make a wild driver, Harry. With 50 million bucks.
What she saw was beyond belief until others, too, faced its hideous, uncontrollable menace. Attack of the 50-foot woman, incredibly huge, with incredible desires for love and vengeance. Agar is the nice-looking young man, introduced by John Hoyt to pretty June Kenny. And when boy meets girl, well, they do what comes naturally. But the loss of love has made this mild-mannered man into a maniac. A maniac who wants to make you a plaything. And the fearsome fact is, he knows how to do it.
I'm your friend.
How would you like to be a living doll? This madman can do with as he pleases. A monster, his own woman, had reason to flee. See, the world that the child in each of us knows. See, a baby doll take a bubble bath in a coffee can.
What are you talking about?
Sally. Tell her. He said tonight he was going to kill us all.
It only takes one of us to go for help.
Feel the fantastic fear of living in a normal world. But being dwarfed by people many times your size.
The show starts in 5 minutes.
Steaming hot coffee. The perfect thing to pick you up and relax you at the same time. Ours is blended specially so you know it's smooth, rich, full up with the deep, mellow flavor and aroma that sets a man on his feet again. Wouldn't a big, delicious cup of coffee taste good right now? By itself or with a tasty snack. Buy it piping hot and hearty, perked fresh and waiting for you at the refreshment center.
If you like pizza made the real Italian way with bubbly cheese, tangy seasonings, pure ingredients, you'll say our pizza is the mosta. Try some now at the refreshment center. Crisp, flavorful fish sandwiches, golden brown and crunchy outside, and tender and juicy inside for a snack or a meal.
The show starts in 4 minutes.
This is a dill pickle, a mighty pretty pickle, especially when he joins you at the show. We have lots of pretty pickles waiting for you at the refreshment center. They're plump, tender, mouth-watering. Wouldn't one taste good right now?
Ah, amigos. This Red's beef tamale, it is good. You will like it. It has the true traditional flavor. It teases your taste. Enjoy Red's tamale. Served piping hot at the snack bar now.
Your attention, please. If you're leaving the theater, please hang your speaker on the speaker stand before starting your car. Don't take chances on accidents which may damage your car. If you accidentally tear off your speaker, please don't be frightened. Simply turn it in. There is no charge for reinstalling speakers.
The show starts in 3 minutes.
Do you see what I see?
I see a beautiful hamburger.
I bet it's a clue.
Yeah, I bet.
We'd better memorize it.
I don't think we'll have to memorize it. The hamburger's winning.
Boy,
My mouth's working. Let's go.
Baseball Joe was a slugger, you know. He made all the pitchers cry. He was fine to admit the reason he hit was T-O-D-D-Y.
Toddy.
That's the night for me.
Toddy.
Try it, Pop, and see.
Toddy.
Man, oh man,
that's the brand new chocolate malt in a can.
Yes, sirree, try Toddy and you'll agree. Toddy is as delicious as the finest tasting soda fountain malted you ever had. Ice cold or steaming hot, ask for Toddy.
Delicious.
On sale now at our snack bar.
Okay. Well, you know, boys and girls, hi, Marvel. Hey, wait a minute. Well, where are you going with that lunchbox? Are you going to school? Oh, you're getting ready for school. Well, that's great. Well, now look, Clarabelle, if you're getting ready for school, here's a swell dessert that you can take along with you. A package of two big Hostess Twinkies. And kids, look here. Clarabelle has his whole lunchbox just filled with Hostess Twinkies. And kids, Hostess Twinkies are one of the most delicious desserts we've ever had here in Dutyville. And they come two in a package, two big ones.
Oh, yes, you're so right, Hottie. Look here, kids. You know, these Hostess Twinkies are really terrific. The delicious sponge cake fingers just melt in your mouth like cotton candy. And see here. Inside every Hostess Twinkie, there's a smooth cream filling that's really out of this world. Well, boys and girls, I know that you're all going to really love Hostess Twinkies. As a dessert, for your lunchbox, or as a between-meal snack. And say, for something really extra special, you ask Mom to serve Hostess Twinkies with ice cream or fruits.
So, kids, you ask Mom to buy some Hostess Twinkies the next time she goes to the store. And you know, boys and girls, in lots and lots of stores, you'll find Hostess Twinkies on a swell stand like this. You ask Mom to look for the picture of the Hostess lady inside the heart. It's on every Hostess counter display.
And now, on with the show.
Professor? Come on, let's go back.
I'm still convinced the half-drive centrifugal blower will give better power thrust.
There he goes with that hot rod Esperanto again.
Dissect that mechanical genius and you'll find spark plugs and multiple cars.
And a supercharger instead of a heart. Maybe he'd give me a tumble if I was a drag wagon.
He just doesn't realize your potential horsepower output, baby, that's all.
All it takes is the right fuel mixture. My RPM reacts like crazy.
This is serious. I've got to overcome the problem of combustion.
Ain't that the truth?
Look, give up. This guy has got a high-octane one-cylinder mind, that's all.
look who's in town. The rah-rah boy.
Yeah, the kid from college.
You're going to give us a break and spend the summer here?
It seemed like a good idea. Until now. I figured you'd be in the clink or the bug house by this time.
Yeah, they had me one, but I drove three psychiatrists nuts. Anyways, here we are, frickin' frack. What are you doing, testing your buggy?
You could say that.
How about a run?
Don't become involved in any infantile exhibitions, John. The consequences are...
Don't get so excited, dear. Remember your oil pressure.
What's the matter? You need special clearance from your guardians?
Can it, Mark.
Caution. I urge caution.
Caution. Is that how they spell yellow in college?
All right. Name it.
For the last time.
Oh, let them alone.
I refuse to be identified with this. We're going back.
Oh, have a heart.
Maybe you better watch this from the sidelines, honey.
You kidding? Make the scene.
We'll make this real interesting. We'll go to Broad Street and Meadow 16th. We'll ride the curbs. After that, we'll head straight for Lake Street.
I'll give the signal. You ready, tall, dark, and loathsome?
Yeah, let's go, Miss Girdle Buster, 1958. Two numbers on the license were a 4 and a 0.
Didn't any of you get a good look at the driver?
Lois did.
I only got a glimpse of him, Dad.
I can certainly identify the car. The last two numbers...
Yeah, I know. A 4 and a 0. You come with me. I think I know where we can locate.
I'm really not sure.
Of course you are. Come along. We'll meet you at the Abernathys later.
Why the sudden lapse of memory? You told me you were sure you recognized that maniac.
Thought occurred to me that being a newcomer here, I wouldn't exactly win a popularity contest by fingering one of the local hotshots.
No, baby. Civic duty comes first.
Now you're beginning to sound like Mr. Philpott.
Get in, young lady. We have a duty to perform.
KMA 367.
Remember now, if anyone asks you, you've been working on this heap all day.
I have. I must be bush by now. I think I'll go.
Come here. And I've been inside rehearsing the combo since noon.
You write jokes as well as you write songs. I like your jokes better.
Look, you want the kids to build that dream car of yours, don't you?
I want the science of mechanical engineering demands.
Oh, all right. Save it, will you?
Well, say, friends.
You haunting us again, Mr. Berrywiff?
Just call me Al. Need the rent money, sonny. Grandma's run out of gin.
Look, now, we're going to take care of you.
The last time somebody said that to me, they had a gun sticking in my back. That's when I decided to invest in property. Property? You hot rod hooligans into me for 3 months' rent.
Look, we're going to have a hop coming up real soon. Now, you're going to get your dough, Dad, I promise you.
Promises? Did you ever try feeding a hungry mother-in-law promises? What's this here? New satellite?
No, that's Dave's design for a new hot rod. We're going to enter it in the all-class sweepstakes.
This will take a pile of green stuff, won't it?
Sure, but it's a cinch to win. Listen, how would you like to buy some stock in that? You know, for 3 months' rent, we're going to name this thing after your old man.
Never had one. My old lady heard a knock at the door, and there I was, cigar and all. Don't forget the landlord.
Well, let's run down those numbers. Try hit and run lever a bit.
Just a hidden from lover. Oh, let me tell you why. You're just a hidden run lover. Let me tell you why. You take a poor boy's heart, and then you say bye-bye. You're just a hidden run lover, and you know it's wrong. You're just a hit-and-run lover, and you know it's wrong. You make a boy love you, and then you say so long. You better watch your stepper, cause one of these days you're gonna find out that crime don't pay. You're just a hit-and-run lover, let me tell you why. You break a poor boy's heart, and then you say a bye-bye.
Take over, baby. Choo-choo, Jabuchi.
Boy, say, young man.
Sorry, sir, you startled me.
Is this a boy?
No.
Look at this, officer. The last two numbers, a 4 and a 0.
Lots of plates end with those two numbers, officer.
Does this car look familiar?
Yes. No. I'm not sure.
Oh, you'd make a terrific court witness. Does this egg beater belong to you?
Sentimentally, yes.
What does that mean in American?
She was a 32 road job when I met her. I brought her to life with a 55 engine and a 36 transmission.
Then I slipped her some 39 tooth gears. On her birthday, I let her have a 42 truck clutch and some solid 56 lifters in a three pot. Also some 57 rocker arms. That's when I knew I was in love with her.
What kind of gibberish is this?
We should have brought a calendar along.
Probably learned to read out of a popular mechanics magazine.
First words I ever said were combustion chamber.
Oh, brother.
Choo-choo, hoochie-boochie kisses drive me wild. Choo-choo, I get weaker than a little child. Choo-choo, choo-choo, you thrill me with your slightest touch.
Sounds like an Indian massacre going on in there. Let's go take a look. Any of these boys?
Obviously, criminal types. Arrest all of them, I say.
Do you see him here?
No, I don't think so.
How about that monster at the piano? The back of his head looks familiar.
The back of his head? What are you, a barber or something? Any of you candidates for a straitjacket scare a few citizens to death with your hot rods this afternoon? Break your necks answering.
But, officer, the innocent never have to confess.
When was the last time you were kicked by a policeman?
So it shouldn't be a total loss. We'll play you a request number. What'll it be?
Disgusting, revolting hoodlums.
Well, I don't know if the boys know that one.
Let's get out of here.
What's keeping you, Lois?
I'm coming.
Whew. Boy, I owe that chick something. For not talking.
I'll collect for her.
It's 3:30. I got to go. What's the matter?
I've been pricing Davy's brainchild.
How much?
All the figures aren't in. I'll give you the bad news tonight.
We've got to cut out.
Are you sure I have to?
Look, I've got to come back here tonight. Now, I can't get away without you.
This is ridiculous. I haven't played the fiddle since I was little. All right, since I was younger.
You know something? You're going to love it just once you get started.
Ready, Dr. Jekyll?
Positively, Mr. Hyde.
How do you do, Abigail? And how do you do, Anastasia?
How do you do?
Mr. Wesley Candidish.
Cavendish.
And his daughter, Louse.
No, Lois. L-O-I-S.
Well, if you insist. No reserved seats, folks. Just squat anywhere.
Mr. Cavendish has joined the firm recently. This is Lois, his daughter.
I'm Abigail, dear. No, you're not, dear. You're Anastasia. Oh, of course. We change names every week. It gets so boring being the same person all the time. My, but you're pretty. I used to look a lot like you. I still do. Won't you sit down?
Thank you.
John will be delighted to meet you.
You'll find him very shy at first. He's led a very secluded life.
Mr. Philpott tells me you play the oboe.
Not very well. Such modesty is so refreshing. You also sing English madrigals, I'm told.
Oh, she loves singing them, don't you, dear?
At the drop of a hat.
Oh, she wears hats. How delightful. Most girls run around nowadays with their hair sticking out of their head. don't they, Anastasia? I'm Abigail this week.
I've been telling Lois about John's sterling qualities.
And the Abernathy estate.
Agatha, serve some tea.
No, ma'am.
Oh, dear, she can be so mean sometimes.
A great man, your father.
May he rest
in peace.
4:30. Where is the young man?
He's probably at the library. His hobby is ornithology.
I have a marvelous idea. While we're waiting, I'll play the harp.
The harp? I might have known it.
Slip into my room.
Are you sure I've got to do this?
Go on, move it.
Always gets in trouble when she gets to that part. Got a nose caught once. Took 7 stitches.
Good evening, Aunt Abigail.
Aunt Anastasia.
Oh, Mr. Philpott. How nice to see you, sir. You're looking very well.
I've seen corpses look better than he does.
That'll do, Agatha.
I thought it was pretty good myself, if I do say it.
Mr. Cavendish, a new member of my firm.
How do you do, sir?
My pleasure. my daughter, Lois?
Charmed, I'm sure, Miss Cavendish.
How do you do?
You may call her Lois. She's been approved.
She plays the oboe and sings excellently.
English madrigals.
Really? Furthermore, she's majoring in home economics. How to run a big home, servants, things like that.
Lois brought her oboe along. After dinner, you two will perform for us. I trust you've been practicing your violin.
Oh, indeed I have, sir. As a matter of fact, I begin my recital next week. I'm been wrestling with Mendelssohn's concerto in E-flat minor.
Mendelssohn lost. We eat in half an hour.
But that's much too early, Agatha.
I got ducats for the basketball game tonight. We eat in half an hour.
Won't you all be seated?
I've seen him before.
Probably in the newspapers. The society page.
Down to business. In accordance with the last will and testament of your late grandfather, John Abernathy I.
May he rest in peace.
Amen.
According to his express wishes, we have completed our annual investigation into the educational and moral progress of his sole heir, John Abernathy III. Our examination reveals the following. College grades, good. Musical progress, excellent. Continued interest maintained in the classics. It would seem that the diligence with which you are pursuing your studies has left you very little time for association with the opposite sex.
Such language.
Your grandfather, being a fair and just man, foresaw that this might happen. He, however, provided that upon your 20th birthday, you be permitted to mingle with certain select and carefully scrutinized young ladies.
How wonderful. You may now start mingling.
That's very thoughtful of Grandfather. Has she been scrutinized?
Most thoroughly.
She has been cleared. Consequently, you will be permitted, under proper supervision, of course,
to, as they say, date her.
Oh, John, this is a great moment in your life.
I'm overwhelmed. I should have been prepared for something like this.
I'll get you a tranquilizer.
Of course, the necessary clearances must be obtained first.
You bring your instrument and the two of you will play duets.
Dinner's ready. Looks pretty awful, so you might as well get it over with.
If you'll excuse me, I'll clean up. Pardon me, please. Excuse me, sir.
What do you think of him?
I hope they lost the formula for any more creeps like him.
Oh.
Here's something special for her front end. Heavy spoke motorcycle wheels and a half-joint triangular locating bar. You're not listening.
You know, I may have trouble getting back to the clubhouse tonight. Do you remember that chick that Philpott brought around looking for me today? Well, she's downstairs.
Lucky she didn't recognize you.
And these shades and this get-up. Besides, I was half smothered with mops and stuff.
She wasn't bad looking for a girl. Personally, I prefer a hopped-up motor.
Man, she's square. She plays the oboe.
No kidding.
And sings madrigals.
Do you sing them? I thought you ate them.
I better get back downstairs.
Hey, about that front end.
She really plays much better than that. I guess she's a little excited tonight, meeting John and all that. Aren't you, dear?
I haven't been so stirred since I fell into the cement mixer.
Well, since you all insist, I'll sing now.
Perhaps I'd better play first, Aunt Abigail, because I'll have to excuse myself soon to practice.
Of course. Duty comes first. You know how your grandfather felt about duty.
Amen. Violin like I do the oboe, which is not good.
Quiet.
Thank you. I hate to run, but I do have to practice.
Oh, well, that's too bad. Lois was hoping, that is, I was hoping that perhaps...
Well, you will join us later for coffee, won't you, dear?
I'll try.
Do come back. You and Lois have so much in common. Not only music, but Lois is a student of ornithology, just as you are.
Are you a bird lover, Miss Cavendish? Well, that's wonderful. We'll have to get together. I'd love to show you my slides.
Really, Mr. Abernathy?
Oh, we'll be chaperoned, of course.
Of course.
Excuse me.
He gave me up for a G-string, and not the kind strippers wear.
He's a little stuffy, I'll admit, but so rich.
Stuffy? A taxidermist's been at him. Do I have to hang around?
Oh, you can slip outside, go for a walk or something.
If I'm found dead, it was no accident. I did it rather than come back here. Will you please excuse me?
Of course.
Come on. Get with it. If only I didn't have to listen to myself.
Come on, from the top. As my old granddaddy used to say, sleep is for the dead, not the working.
You tell your granddaddy.
Shh. He can hear every word you say. My aunts are convinced that his ear is at every keyhole.
I just ran out of rosin. I was on my way to get some.
Do you always take that shortcut? Your fiddle seems to play without rosin. Even without a player. You know, those glasses fooled me. First time we met, you were hiding in a broom closet.
Really, Miss Cavendish, you must be mistaken, because I...
That line doesn't work so good with that getup. Where are we going?
We?
Well, if I stay here, I'm just liable to tell Mr. Philpott where and how we met. He'd just love to know that you were the one that was driving the hot rod that nearly ripped his pants off.
You know, that's a form of blackmail.
There are others. I could scream and say you attacked me.
You're a sweet kid. You and your oboe.
And you and your violin. Shall we depart?
You got me. Let's go. go.
Like this?
Usually. Except when I get mad, then I really let go. Why? Shall I take you home?
Take me home? No, I love it. Go ahead, get mad.
Bad in here. Makes you look good.
Go, Bray at the moon.
Where's the playboy, or is this his night out with the Vanderbilts? We didn't get around to finishing our run.
Well, aren't you the glutton for punishment? He can take you in or out of a gas buggy. You know that.
Not tonight. I feel good.
Yeah, I can smell the reason why.
I installed myself a new set of carbs today. I'd like to try them out on social item number one.
Well, for a guy who hasn't worked since he ran errands for a bookie, you sure come up with the dough when you want it.
Yeah, I'm talented that way.
Hi, John.
Hi, Dick.
What's the matter? Who died?
We all did. I just got the final figures in.
How much?
4,100 fish, not counting our own sweat and blood.
Are we downhearted, gang?
Yes. Yeah. Look, now we got the combo sounding pretty good. Why don't we make a series of hops?
If we do real big, we'll clear a $50 bill on them. That means 82 dances.
I got a surefire scheme to raise some scratch.
All we need is a few simple tools. Some guts.
It's before we should have the dough for the car.
Who's going to drive it in the sweepstakes? We'll all be in jail.
I said it takes guts.
Look, now, I'll see that we get the money without stirring up the police. Come on, Dick, let's run down, believe me, one time.
Believe me, this is my first affair. Handle my heart with care. Gee, how I love you. So help me. You know the way I feel. Say this romance is real. Gee, how I love you.
Haven't I met you somewhere before?
I hope.
I'm afraid not. One of life's bigger disappointments.
I can remedy that.
The way you hold me tight. I swear by all the stars above, you are my only love. So help me. You know the way I feel. Say this romance is real. Gee, how I love you. I love the way you kiss goodnight, the way you hold me tight. I swear by all the stars above, you are my only love. So help me. You know the way I feel. Say this romance is real. Gee, how I love you.
Friends, friends, break it up. You kids will never know how much this hurts me.
I ain't felt this bad since I was hijacked back in 29.
What is it?
Well, you strip it of its whys and wherefores, and it's an eviction notice. Nothing personal. Just money.
Well, when do we have to get out?
At the end of the month. Now, I ain't got nothing to do with this, kids. That man down at City Hall wants the taxes.
Hey, Jack. I met a pal of your brother's, Johnny Red Eye. You ever heard of him?
Yeah. Who hasn't?
Said your brother's doing okay. Got himself a trustee's job in the potato room. Makes brew out of the peel and sells it to the cons. Tell your old man he's doing okay.
Yeah, I will. As soon as he gets out.
This does it.
Well, I'm generally the shy retiring type, but especially the retiring type.
Look, give her an air, will you?
I'd like to. Her own. On a platter.
Well, I have a thought. Gene Vincent's a friend of mine. He's a bug on these souped-up can openers. He might just do a benefit for us. I'll talk to him tomorrow.
You bring that to pass and you're a lifetime member.
Come on, waltz me around, Willie.
I should have worn my wrestling shoes.
Oh, it's just that I want to make time in a hurry.
You don't like what you see?
Like I said, baby, you need somebody older, more mature, like me.
I'm cutting in.
Beat it, kid. Go sing a song.
Well, that's that. Shall we dance?
Yourself a zip gun. Come on, Lawson. Each other. You know, you were getting pretty chummy with him. I'd keep away from characters like Mark if I were you.
Would you be getting jealous?
Jealous yet.
I'll talk to Gene Vincent tomorrow night.
I'll go with you.
Do you know what you're letting yourself in for? I'm a fortune hunter. In an amateurish sort of way.
Then maybe you better show me what some of your weapons are. That's the opening shot. I'm in trouble.
We'd better rejoin the Caterwauling Society.
I'll make my entrance from my room.
Okay.
See you later.
Turn on the radio and leave them alive. I'll grab a little chicken and dance all night. They're gonna dance in the street tonight. Dance in the street tonight. Gonna dance to the beat, to the hot and the sweet. They're gonna dance in the street tonight. Well, yeah.
going to the bar, going to the store, and we're going to the hop. Up then while we're dancing, tell you what I'm gonna do. Every now and then I'm gonna steal a kiss from you and dance in the street tonight. When I dance in the street tonight, when I dance in the street to the hot and the sweet, we're gonna dance in the street tonight. Oh, yeah. Well, we're gonna dance in the street.
Vincent, John Abernathy.
I hear you sing a mean song, man.
Oh, well, thank you, Jean.
Sorry, Lois. I checked with the brain department today, and I'm starting on a 3-week tour tomorrow. Maybe I can help you out when I get back.
Well, it was worth a try, anyway.
Lois seems to think you got something the kids might go for. If they do, things happen pretty quick in this business. I'll be doing a guest shot on my show tonight.
That's out, Jean, but thanks just the same.
John can't risk a public appearance. He might be recognized.
I've got a thought. Why not gimmick him up? You know, we've got the shaggy mane and the shivering spine and the rubbery legs. Why not dress him up in a cool set of shrubbery and some real classy threads? And, you know, like one of those Greenwich Village characters on Cloud Nine?
Yeah, we might get away with that.
I don't think we'd better try it.
Oh, 4,100 pieces of eight. You said you'd raise it.
Take him down to the makeup man.
Okay, come on.
Count Brass, if one of your local fans.
Can I have your autograph?
Full rehearsal. Dance routine. Roll the tape, dancing to the bop.
Well, there's a little juke joint on the outside of town where the cops pick them up and they lay them down. Well, you get your gal, I get mine, and we'll get together and we'll have a good time. And we'll dance a little bit to the bop, dance a little bit to the bop. We'll dance a little bit to the bop. Well, I dance to the rock and roll, and I dance, 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 we'll dance, 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 yeah. When I dance, we'll dance to the rock and roll. Now I gotta get it. And then the cats come rocking into the tune. Some come single like me and you. I dance into the bop, he's there to lie. Well, now when we get right, we'll dance all night. And they'll dance a little bit to the bop, dance a little bit to the bop, to the bop. I dance a little bit to the bop. Well, they dance to the rock and roll. Yeah, and I dance, dance, dance. We'll dance, dance, dance. Yeah, and I dance, dance, dance. We'll dance, dance, dance. When I dance, we'll dance to the rock and roll. Yeah. Bob, dance a little bit to the bop. Dance a little bit to the bop. We'll dance to the rock and roll. Yeah, dance, dance, dance. We'll dance, dance, dance. Now dance, dance, dance. We'll dance, dance, dance. We'll dance. We'll dance to the rock and roll.
Now hear me, you double R chicks. Your old daddy Vincent's come up with the find of the century. This bobcat's really got a sound that sends. Give him a sample. What'll it be?
By some coincidence, I happen to have some music here.
What's he gonna...
Annie Laurie.
Well, we don't need no music. What'll we call him?
Jackson Dalrymple. How's that?
Yeah. Take it, Jackson.
Annie Laurie, boys.
Well, 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 I got a girl named Annie Laurie. Well, she got eyes of blue and kisses sweet as wine. Well, 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 I'm on my way to see my Annie Laurie. Well, she's the one for me and she really treats me fine. She gave me her promise to be true. She gave me her promise not to leave. And I know that I'm gonna never, 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 ever find, well, a girl like Annie Laurie for me. When I see my Annie Laurie, well, I'm gonna take her in my arms and hold her tight. Well, I'm gonna tell her just how much I really love her. Well, I'm gonna be real glad when I get to her house tonight.
I got you down on tape, Jackson. How would you like you to do the other side of my brand new record?
Oh, Gene, that's great, but I don't think I better, really.
Oh, Lois will convince you. She's one of the best convincers I know.
I'll sure give it a good whirl.
Thanks, Gene, for everything.
Yeah, thanks, thank you. Gene. Bye-bye.
Get in character, Jackson.
You're a beautiful bunch of young kittens, and I love you one and all, but old Jackson ain't had his dinner yet. I'm not fortified now. Arise and rejoice with me. Let me pass through. I'll talk to you later.
Oh, yeah.
Is that you, John? You, John?
Anastasia!
What is it?
I saw him. He's back. Just like he said he'd be.
Him?
Just like him to go snooping around the house at this time of the night. Agatha, Father John is back.
That old goat? Probably check him to see if anybody's been at his booze.
Oh! Then he's in John's room, quick!
Beaver.
it?
We're looking for your grandfather. We saw him downstairs.
Well, I had the impression he was dead.
That wouldn't mean a thing to him.
If he tries to bother you, you just tell him where to go.
According to Agatha, he's there already. Good night.
Good night.
Heading for the top 10 after only 2 weeks is this swinging thing by Jackson Dalrymple. Sensational new singing discovery.
You're just a hit and run lover. Let me tell you why. You're just a hit and run lover.
Oh, is he a doll?
I wonder if those whiskers tick off.
They're crazy. I'm gonna make Chris grow some, too.
He probably can. He's only 17.
Then I'll drop him.
You say bye-bye. You say bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Gather around the tubes, kids. This is Earl McDaniel, and we've done it again. The first exclusive interview with Jackson the Beard Dalrymple, the country's latest singing star.
Jackson, what does it feel like to be famous?
Man, it's wild. It's like I'm in orbit or something, just floating around, you know.
You know, your voice has been called the hottest sound to come along in some time. How do you account for it?
Well, first of all, I want to say that I agree with you. It's wild. It's a sound that I just can't explain. I just dig it up out of my diaphragm, and it shoots up here in my throat. I untie these vocal cords, and it leaps right out there in space, Jack. I mean, it floats right out like gossamer wings. It's beautiful, Daddy. It swings.
What do you hope to accomplish in the next couple of years, Jackson?
Well, as you can see, I'm very, very handicapped by my inferiority complex, but if I can shake it, I think I'm set.
What do you say we give your new record a spin? Are you ready?
Oh, am I ready? I want to hear it.
Let's do it.
Let's put it on. That's why.
This is my first affair. Handle my heart. How I love you. So
I hear by the grapevine things are looking up for you kids.
We've got close to $2,000 toward the car.
Well, what about my rent money then? I got 7 kids and an elephant waiting for something to eat.
It's being put in a special account for us. As soon as all the money we need is in it, it'll be turned over to us.
Well, I ain't of a mind to wait. Rumors going around that some singer's setting you kids up.
That's true.
Well, the police got other ideas. They were out here this morning. They figure it's coming from this rash of car stripping that's been going on.
What'd they do, search the place?
Like they were looking for flies in a raisin pie. Mighty disappointed or didn't find anything. Now, about that there dojo.
In a couple of weeks, we should have it.
Well, it'll be a mighty happy day for me. Keep cutting it, kids. Keep cutting it.
You know, this thing's getting out of hand. They want me to go on a tour of one-nighters. How much money have we got in the bank?
Nearly $3,000.
I gotta get out of this beard while the getting's good. Even my aunts are getting suspicious. You know, I haven't been home one night in the last 3 weeks. This whole bit's gotta go.
Well, you can't quit now. Another couple of weeks and you'd have it made. Look, Gene Vincent is due back in town next week. If the two of you could get together and give one big session, well, then you'd have enough money, and then you could vanish.
It's an idea. Jimmy said he could get the high school gym free, didn't he? We should be able to do it. Then Jackson Dalrymple could vanish.
It was sure fun while it lasted.
Just fun?
Mom, those whiskers tickle.
I'll be glad when I can put this thing down a garbage disposal. Good night, honey.
Good night, dear.
Thank you.
Stand tight. John Abernathy, stay where you are. I've got a pistol pointed at you. You have no right to come back here and annoy us.
I just dropped in to see how things were going. I guess I'll be on my way.
That's not Papa's voice. John Abernathy the Third.
That boy on the telephone didn't lie.
What boy?
He didn't tell us his name. He just told us that you were making a monkey out of the Abernathy family tree.
He said you were rolling rocks all over the city.
And we demand an explanation.
Okay, well, here goes.
I hope you don't mind my dropping in.
Poor thing, she's hard of hearing. We just have to repeat it all to her.
So I came on in, and I guess that's about it.
Well, I'll be...
caught without a corset.
That happened to you once, remember?
Shush, Agatha. And you tried to raise the money by rocking and rolling. How perfectly...
delightful.
Idiotic.
And dangerous if Mr. Philpott should ever find out.
Really, John, you must stop it.
Yeah, well, I am. One more farewell appearance, and then Jackson, the bear Dalrymple, dies.
Poor thing, and him so young.
I've got the most exquisite idea.
Here we go again.
We'll perform at John's farewell concert, too. Give it prestige.
Give me some ether, and I'll put him to sleep till it's over.
But John insists, don't you, dear?
Yeah, well...
we'll do it.
Just for you.
Okay. Good night.
Good night.
Mark, I gotta see you. Listen, the cops were at my place. They went over the joint an inch at a time.
I got the same business this morning.
I tell you, we're getting hot, Mark.
The main thing is they didn't find anything.
Oh, suppose they stumble onto some of the stuff.
How they could connect us with it?
I don't care. I just want to get them off my back.
All right, don't strain. Everything will be all right.
I understand you tried to queer the Jackson Dalrymple bit.
Who says?
There's only one louse I know who would phone his aunts. It's our considered opinion that you're a heel and that you can make yourself scarce permanently. Take your time, though. No hurry.
You got about 3 minutes.
Hey, kid! Am I interrupting something?
No, he was just going to show me how to play marbles.
Found a car this morning. No wheels, no tires. Figured I ought to tell you. It's going to be awful rough on somebody. Just remember it. See you in jail. Now, about those marbles.
You've got a 3-hour recording session waiting for you. Grab your whiskers and let's go. Come on.
Come on, Jocko. Let's get out of this nursery school.
See you at the hop this afternoon?
Yeah.
You sure Gene Vincent will be there?
Yeah.
Hey, I meant to tell you. A guy delivered a harp to the gym today. Said your aunt sent it down.
I know it. She says we all insist that she do a solo.
Okay, take it easy. I'll see you, huh? A harp solo?
Oh, man, that was a rough session.
This your car?
Yeah.
Come around the back. Go on.
Wow, what's the matter?
Just go around to the back.
Open it up. Look, I didn't steal that stuff. Somebody planted it.
Oh, that'll make a stirring defense. Throw it at the jury.
Wait a minute. Let me guess.
An anonymous phone call?
Whatever it was, you're coming with me.
Hey, miss!
Come on.
John Abernathy's heir. Disgraceful.
Get our boy out of there.
They won't release him till morning.
The hops today.
The what? The hop, you cube. Ruined. Absolutely ruined.
We'll just carry on without him. Lois, you tell those young people nothing's changed. The show must go on.
Well, it's too bad your kid's crapped out. Them snake eyes will get you every time.
A rotten frame-up.
Don't we all know it? I think about the only thing for you kids to do is pay me off. 4 months rent, plus interest, plus carrying charges.
The DAC is the bank account. He's holding it for claims.
Now, that hits a low blow where it hurts. Right here.
He won't release it till the case is finished.
And I was planning on buying a bathtub for Grandma so she could make her own joy juice. All right, it's time for the pros to step in. You kids make yourselves scarce. Go on, get out of here, beat it. Come on, shorty.
You got me?
Oh, hurry, Lambkins, get everything ready.
I thought you said that Mark wanted to see me here.
You misunderstood me, friend. I said if you're Mark, M-A-R-K, you'll come here.
Hi, kid. I'm Johnny Red Eye. I met your brother on Folsom. Or was it San Quentin?
Yeah, I heard about you.
Good. That'll save time. My pal thinks you can get him out of a jam. Rent money, something like that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Look, it's loaded. Something about you and a buddy stripping cars and pinning it on somebody else.
Look, I'm no rat.
Stripping cars. Kid stuff. If your brother knew, he'd die of shame. Why don't you get into something more honorable, like safe cracking or burglary? How about it, kid?
Take it easy with that.
Your train state's evidence. They'll let you off on a suspended sentence, put you out on probation, then you can get into something that'll make your folks proud.
Ain't it just a talking, friend?
You sure they'll let me off with a suspended?
Surely, sure. Johnny's a legal whiz.
If I was a little more crooked, I could have been a lawyer or a judge. How about it, kid? Should we go to the station?
Heavenly. Thanks, Dad. What's cooking?
I didn't guess.
What's with the harp?
Uh-oh, I was afraid of this.
Good evening.
Hi.
John! Oh, I knew they wouldn't leave you in that terrible place. They must have found out you were an Abernathy. No Abernathy has ever been in jail.
Except your grandfather.
I don't know what happened. They just opened up the cage and let me out. To work, Mademoiselle Fortune Hunter.
use for a little harmless fun. Like tearing the joint apart?
Yeah. When I see my Annie Laurie, well, I'm gonna take her into my arms and hold her tight. Well, I'm gonna tell her just how much I really love her. Ooh, I'm gonna be real glad I wanna get to her house tonight. Well, I'm gonna be real glad when I get to her house tonight. Well, I'm gonna be real glad when I get to her house tonight.
I guess you had it, buddy.
It doesn't look too hard, eh?
Oh,
It isn't. It's just a beat-up minuet.
Pardon me, but may we, in accordance with Grandfather's will, Section 7, Article 2, go outside and study the effects of moonlight on young people? Thank you.
Excellent idea.
Dryden, shall we dance?
How nice of you to ask.
To this music?
Hey, kid.
Am I interrupting something? You ought to have a sign out, man and equipment working.
You know, I could report you to the police commissioner for butting in at a time like this.
Oh, he won't mind. I'm making the department richer by a couple of $100. 17 traffic citations. Everything from double parking to endangering Mr. Philpott's life.
$200. He'll be leading a much more conservative life from now on, officer.
I see what you mean. Well, I hate to leave.
We can stand it.
Let's see now, where were we?
About here.
You're just a hit and run lover. Let me tell you why. You're just a hit and run lover. Let me tell you why. Well, you take his poor boy's heart away, and then you say bye bye. Well, you say bye bye. You say bye bye. Bye bye.
Yeah, I don't know about you, but Outrock Gang seemed to really lay the groundwork for the much goofier beach party movies that made AIP a ton of money in the early 60s. Caricatures of hip teens, goofy comedy, and a lot of very silly adults. Well, that'll do it for tonight. I promise we won't show any other JD movies for a while. I'll see you next week. Cheers.